And Thomas, I invite you in to wrap up our day. Whew. Yeah, that's going to be our...
That's going to be an interesting one.
It's going to be a good run.
So we're just standing here between the music, the cocktails, dinner, dance, and fantastic food. So, but a few reflections before the big thank you. And just building on what you said, Nana, on, well, we'll be having a fluid program in the future and people decide what they learn. I would push us even one further. If you have a multimodal program, why not have at the end of module one, if we do it here, and people decide not only what they want to do, but also where they want to do it. Remember what we said, it's a camp. The future of SEDEB is not necessarily campus bound, it's a campus everywhere. So what about asking the participants, out of your context, the next module in four months, where do you want to do it? They have to make a pitch, they have to argue as to why and how, right? So I think we can push those ideas to the edge. We can be really aggressive in a positive manner of disruptive. We need to stay on the edge. When I review what the day we spent today, it's all about people, all about collectiveness. When we talked about this morning the future of work, and it quickly morphed into the future of life. What is our future collectively? How are we going to make the rules? As Dominic said, I don't give a shit about today, right? What do we make sure? What is now the trente décisive, right? This is the next 30, the next decisive 30 years. And it's today where we have to start to make the difference. So I think that quickly morphed from future of work into how do we create the planet for our children and unborn grandchildren. And if you look at then the safety conversation, which went from the classic approach from policies, procedures, compliance, and how do we make it stick with people and the carrot and the stick, the usual management tools we all grew up and have been very successfully applying into, as Muriel puts it, goddamn care about the people. And then the critical question, how do I know how to care about people, right? So again, food for our collective thought, morphing into from the classical management style we all have been successful in, because we grew up in that corporate world. We were rewarded, promoted, and got always the positive feedback the way we behaved, because we bloody delivered the results, right? All those old KPIs. And I think for SEDEB going forward out of this conversation, I take a little bit of a license not to kill, but a license to really unravel some of those classical KPIs thinking even more aggressively than we have been trying to do over the past years already collectively with SEDEB. I think we just owe it to ourselves, to our participants, to our organizations, and to the society at large to be much more groundbreaking, much more explicit, and much more deliberate in making that difference. Again, those I think were some of the conversations of this morning and this afternoon. And then clearly the dreaming and visioning, absolutely fantastic, right? I mean, there's a lot of great ideas. When Ravi pulled out a little bit today, I think the tomorrow is just the beginning. And I think if you want to remember one thing out of this fantastic gathering, besides meeting people, having fun and laughed, and getting a bit of the typical SEDEB spirit in those conversations, is the next 50 years of SEDEB have started today. And you can look back on that and say, I was part of that first day one of the next 50 years. The way it's going to be, you can always say, I've been part in those first initial conversations. And I think collectively, all of us of SEDEB would like to thank you for that, because you are SEDEB. We are just kind of the guardians, we're just kind of the facilitators, but you are SEDEB. And I think that shows the strength of a community, and I heard the word collectiveness, community, a lot today. And I think we need to better build and be better promoting that uniqueness, that USP SEDEB has developed over the years. We need to be more explicit, more deliberate. And I know that Sylvie and David and many other of you always push us very much, for God's sake, just be clear on your message. What is it? But then when you have a mouton en cinq pattes, it's not always that easy to describe a mouton en cinq pattes. And some of you, and Xavier, I'm picking on you, right? We had a long relationship for many years, but you never experienced SEDEB, right? I've been talking to you about what SEDEB is, but right today, you lived through a day of SEDEB. And I think it changed perspectives, and I think we need to be able to get out of this. How can we make people live SEDEB without actually having to be here? And if the campus becomes a multinational campus, a hybrid campus, a digital campus, how do we create that famous smell of the place, of SEDEP, in Timbuktu, on Mars, or somewhere on a team session, right? So, and I think that's a little bit the collective challenge. We got a lot of ideas from you on this last session about dreaming and visioning. So thank you for that. The thank you list is very long. I mean, if you can imagine the effort and the work which is all behind. And I would like, out of completeness, allow me to read the list because I think it's important to recognize. So of course, our facilitators, Peter and Antoine, I think a lot of work and prep work in there. For those who know me, you will never see that again in your life, right? I do not have 12 pages of a script as to how the day works. So this is thanks to you guys to get a red, yellow, intuitive guy with guts feelings to be preparing stuff, right? Well done. And we pay for them on the top of it. There's something wrong. So the visual supports, I mean, if you have Husatik and Alan Lopez on the impression, is he here, Alan? No, he's there. The live stream, guys from live stream, right? You have Gustav and Guy and Gregoire. So all the live streams on for our people out on the open network. So a lot of setup till 1 o'clock in the morning to make sure everybody participates. And Jean-Luc, of course, on the sound system, the video. Ariane, I think she has been interviewing several of you during the day. The drone, you see all the spies around, right? So everything's up for sale, €55, the DVD. So if you want to buy it. So the drone is out there, the photographer, Natalie. You have been seeing Natalie around a lot of time taking pictures, right? All our Live for Good, you had the opportunity to meet our Live for Good community, right? So they're still here to benefit from the drinks, the beer, the games, all the things you're discovering there. The flowers, of course, with Sophie and her team. They spent 12 hours yesterday doing all those flower arrangements, all that 3 o'clock in the morning at the ranch, she's picking up the flowers and then a handmade. And then, of course, I have to switch the page. The maze and Antoine, of course, some of you have experienced, right? The maze, the 3D, the future of executive coaching. Sylvie, you must try it if you haven't done yet. It's really interesting. And then, of course, the SEDEP team. So Coco, Sylvain, Sylviane, Céline, Beatrice, Eva, Brigitte on the reception, Philip, Fred. Philip, it wouldn't have happened without you. I know you were sweating till last month on technology. Fred and Magali, of course, everything will be honky-dory for the great gala dinner and the cocktails. Aurore, a lot of work behind the scenes on getting things done, right? Benoit, all the nice little drawings you will get, of course, thanks to Benoit, who is doing that. All our facilitators, right? All our faculties, everybody who has contributed actively in the preparation. But it all wouldn't have happened without one person. The person who didn't sleep in the last 10 days. Where's Mumu? Bravo, Mumu! And in the spirit of the community, I would like to reach out to Sylvie. She sent me a nice text message last night and saying, listen, I'm reaching out to the SEDEP community. My husband has been traveling back and forth to the Ukrainian border, bringing food and helping the refugees. And there's a 19-year-old young lady. She has a job at Carré Melun as of 5th of July. So she has all the permits and she's looking for a room, a student housing, anything between here and Melun, around Melun. So reaching out to the community, if any of you knows of somebody, has something available, I'm sure that just reach out to Sylvie while you're here. That would be extremely helpful and a contribution for making the life of a 19-year-old refugee a better life. That's what we're all about, helping our community. Thank you. What's next? So what's next is we are going to have Pia Salvia and her husband, Naomi Israel, giving us music and a concert for about half an hour, and then they continue on playing. She's a harpist who finished Berkeley, this College of Berkeley on harp, and she's moving next month back to Los Angeles. She also has done some CDs, if somebody wants to pick them up, and she's doing modern music based accompanied by her harp, not by a guitar. So it's a very different sound and a very different experience, and I hope you enjoyed it. And we're going to celebrate also the latest SEDEP new member, Transvalor, who joined us 3 weeks ago. So Stefan Heitz is here. See, when we talk about the angel, he's coming. So Stefan will be... We're just talking about you, Stefan. Exactly. So we'll have a little honor, a cocktail of honor for our latest new member later on. So feel free. Cocktails are open as of 6 o'clock, and then the dinner starts at 7:30. But I guess, Mimi, you will have the bell, right? Exactly. What? No. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed it. And it's just the beginning of the unofficial part. Now, the typical setup thing, right? Open bar, champagne. Nothing happens at setup without champagne. And I was impressed. Not a single phone rang during the day. So no one is paying a bottle of champagne tonight. I can see that. So it's all on the house. So enjoy it. Thank you. And see you around in the next few hours, including the dinner in here. Thank you.